It's so unbelievable. All these are made in Kenya.
Yes, they are. All made in Kenya.
So what is the name of your brand?
Well, we're called Lakira. We're a brand that supports the African beads, African jewelry. It's all handmade here in Kenya. The most, like, all the beads around here that you're looking at date centuries back.
Yeah.
For example, the Samburu beads. These are very old and very local beads. A Samburu warrior would dress up as a lion, go for a hunt, and if he successfully killed the lion barehanded or with a spear, he would receive one bead as a gift of his bravery. Just one bead. So you can imagine how many lions we have.
A lot, yeah?
So a woman would then later accept this from all her admirers and wear it on a on a collar. Yeah. So all these beads here.
All right. So they are the more, now these are the different designs?
Yes. Then we have just made them in very nice different designs, very African designs. Like these are, this represents the spikes. The spikes that the Samburus men and women do, you know, wear around their necks. And this represents the African amulets, the flat amulets, which also the Maasai women all have on their necklaces.
Okay.
And we go secondly to this bead, the chevron beads, perhaps the most expensive
bead. That's what they call?
They're called the chevron beads, yes. The most expensive bead in history.
Whoa. Why is it this expensive?
Only the kings and chiefs back in those days were allowed to wear this.
So that's the reason as to why.
Yes. If you didn't have a high status, you could not possess these beads. Only leaders and chiefs in those days could have this bead. The trade beads of Africa. This was used in the trade. Because these were used in trading.
This was the barter trade, the exchange.
Yes, you know about it.
Yes.
Yeah, so these were called trade beads. They came from Venice. So a bead could buy a slave. At those times, they were exchanged for ivory, gold, and slaves. Three things the old world wanted from Africa. So these are very important trade beads.
And how about the bangles?
These are done with semi-precious stones, because we also deal with semi-precious stones. So we get beads from all over the world, and then we design them here in our workshop.
Right.
We have ladies who work with us, help us string and design.
Yeah.
So it's all locally done here.
And then there's a stone that has really been interesting me. This one.
It's called the moonstone. It's also a very semi-precious stone.
Is it because they are they rare? That's the reason.
Some of these are very rare.
Or let me ask this question: what makes a stone special? Because all these are special stones. Or there are those which are more special than others.
They are. The precious ones are like the ruby, emeralds, the sapphire, tanzanites. Those are ranked as the special beads. But these are semi-precious.
Yeah.
So they're in the semi range. They're not in the very precious range. Also, a stone is known from the grades. The higher the grade, the higher the quality, the higher the price. Yeah. So that is how they're ranked.
Now, and then another thing I'm noticing is the metals. They have this vintage kind of finish. Tell us about it.
The oxidized look. Yes.
Just like this one.
Yes. So this is how originally, like, people nowadays don't like the blink a lot. This is the oxidized look is what the, but if you shine, if you take a silver polished cloth, shine, just clean them, they'll shine. Yeah. They will shine. But because clients nowadays prefer a very oxidized, dull look, so that is why we do this. Yeah, if you look at our jewelry, most of it is very oxidized. The lapis.
Yeah.
This is also a very special stone. Like the mummies in Egypt. This is a stone from Afghanistan. Who are buried always with a piece of lapis with them.
Even
if you go search today, there are mummies there. Yes, they'll have a small lapis bead next to them. And if you look at it, it has some gold flakes in it. So it carried status as well.
Yeah, it has.
Yeah, you'll see some gold speckles in them.
Amazing. What about these white ones?
These are the pearls, freshwater pearls.
Just
like this,
what we have here.
These are all freshwater pearls. They come in different, some of them come in different colors. You must have seen the whites all over, but yes, they do come in this.
The finish is so nice.
Yeah. Freshwater pearls.
Oh, so beautiful. All right. So, guys, it's all about having unique jewelry, something precious, something that you can never find elsewhere.
Custom make, because we have a workshop, like I mentioned, so we can design whatever you want, you know, adjust whatever you want.
How about your shop?
Yes, we are on General Mathenge, mm-hmm. number 43 Harmony Center.
All right, then. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Visit us.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much.